My name's Gary Wilson, and my connection to the Sheriff's Department goes back to 1992. I was part of a class of 31, I would call very green deputy sheriffs at that time. We had a real big ambition of doing some great things in the sheriff's department at that time, but we had no idea exactly what that looked like. So I was part of a class of 31 deputies that was part of a pretty large, I think at that time I was considered a pretty decent size academy, specifically because the department was starting to grow quite a bit with new buildings. I think Building 22 was just opening around that time. And so they were trying to build up the staff to make sure that that building could open properly. Just in general, I was a deputy sheriff from 1992. And eventually worked my way up through the ranks to become the sheriff for 4 years. And then I retired from the Denver Sheriff's Department in 2018. I think I was part of a legacy that was created prior to even getting on the Sheriff's Department. The Sheriff's Department had been valued in the city as a rather diverse department. And we were blessed to have people like John Simonette, who really valued diversity in the department. We were also blessed to have organizations who advocated, such as the Black Sheriff's Protective Association, LALE, and I would even say the unions, who really advocated for diversity in the department. And so we had, I would say, very open ideologies to diversity, and not just diversity, but inclusion, so that that diversity was used to the best of the benefit to meet the mission and the vision of the department, where I believe I was able to build upon that was, we started to see an advancement. I think I was part of that, again, building off of a foundation that was already set, of seeing that diversity rise up through the ranks and seeing more diversity in our executive management, which was occurring, but also I think it grew up under my administration also. And I could see that it's continuing to grow. And I'm hearing great stories about people being the first of this and the first of that. That is always an amazing story to listen to. But I was honored to be selected as really the first sheriff that was selected inside the sheriff's department, and to be able to lead such an amazing department. The advice I would give is that it can be done, and it's rewarding. I would also be transparent to say it's challenging. There was no question being the first was challenging, but it was more rewarding than it was challenging. And as public servants, I think the greatest thing we can offer to this field is a recognition that it's not about us. It's really about others and sacrificing for the betterment and the protection of the community that we serve. And at times, yes, you will be doing quite a bit of sacrificing, specifically for private, what normally might be your evenings and your weekends, especially as you get more up in the executive ranks. But the reward is so much greater than the sacrifice that you will be committing to. And there's nothing greater when you really know that you're making a difference. in the lives of the people that you serve. And there's no money, there's no other things that really equates to when you actually can visualize that impact and hear it directly from the people that you're serving. So I knew too much is given, much is expected. And for us, really raising the bar and raising the standard was understood by me. And that we were not going to be held to the same standard as the average citizen, which is expected. We had a lot of power, and still, the sheriff's department does. And that power comes with a bunch of accountability. And so it meant a lot, and it was understood that we had to raise the standard in regards to how we operated. One of the things that we did to align ourselves under a higher standard was we really started to advance the legacy of John Simonette, who really was the first to bring accreditation to the department. And we began to align ourselves with different bodies of accreditation that ultimately led us to the Triple Crown accreditation. We also started to expand in spaces that made our job safer with implementing the K-9 unit so that we could make sure that the jails were safe and surrounding areas of the jail were safe. And then we also wanted to just demonstrate more of our community presence. And so we also re-implemented the mounting unit so that the mounted unit could be out and part of those parades. And we started to just do more with the community and bring back a presence where we understood that we needed to connect with the community to make sure that we were meeting community expectations, and we had a presence of not being seen as an adversary, but more of a participant, because we were part of the community. The community aspect, along with being a protector of the community, I understood that, and that meant a lot. And I know that for our deputies, they also got that message too. The sheriffs, the deputy sheriffs, you have an extremely dangerous job, but it's an important job, and it's a job that for the close of this time, this month, this history, I would ask everyone to just reflect upon the importance of diversity, the importance of inclusion, the importance of making sure that all community members are represented, and also the fact that we're better when we think in that manner. And so, although we're closing out in one regard, the month of Black History, it is also just a point in time where we can just reflect on just really the importance of diversity and the importance of that inclusion. I would like to wish a happy Black History Month to all members of the City and County of Denver.